thyroid disorders in hemodialysis. There is no doubt that the thyroid and the kidneys, there is a crosstalk between both organs. So there is a complex interplay in health and as well in disease, like in CKD, for example. The thyroid affects the kidney in growth. During early development, even the kidney mass is affected by the thyroid function, as well as the renal. So, to repeat, we have the effect of the thyroid on the growth and development of the kidneys as well as the renal physiology. The thyroid affects the renal physiology in two ways, pre-renal as well as renal effect. Pre-renal through its effect on the cardiac output and on the hemodynamics of the whole blood. So the renal blood flow increases with thyroxine and decrease with thyroxine deficiency. The metabolic effects are mainly through its effect on the RAS system as well as increased sodium tumor reabsorption and increased calcium reabsorption as well. Our agenda today will include the effect of the thyroid dysfunction on the kidney, the thyroid dysfunction in chronic kidney disease, and the thyroid dysfunction during dialysis. First, how can thyroid dysfunction affect the normally acting kidney? Hyperthyroidism, as we just mentioned, will increase the cardiac output, will increase the heart rate, has a positive entropic as well as chronotropic effect, and so it will increase the renal blood flow, increasing filtration force and glomerular filtration in hyperthyroidism, and the contrary will occur in hypothyroid patients. The main topic today about thyroid dysfunction in CKD, this will be followed about with the core of our talk, which is the thyroid dysfunction during dialysis. First, how can CKD as a disease affect the thyroid function? It affects the thyroid function in many ways, one of which is the blunted or the delayed response of TSH to the thyroid releasing hormone. There are many other mechanisms, but still the most important is the decreased peripheral conversion of T4 to T3. We all know that T4 is the main hormone secreted by the thyroid, and it is peripherally converted to T3. Chronic kidney disease will affect this peripheral conversion and will result in low T3. This is the most common finding in CKD. In CKD, low T3 is the commonest laboratory finding, while subclinical hypothyroidism is the commonest thyroid disorders encountered in these patients. Low thyroid state is not hazardous in this patient. It defends against protein wasting. So misguided attempts to replete thyroid hormone may worsen or may affect the protein status in this patient and may increase wasting and protein breakdown. What is the prevalence of subclinical hypothyroidism in patients with CKD? In 2008, this survey was done in Italy, including more than 3,000 patients, of which about 18%, approximately 18%, have subclinical hypothyroidism. This was not the only finding. They also concluded that the prevalence of subclinical hypothyroidism increased with decreased decline from 7 to about 17 when GFR decrease from above 90 to below 60. In 2014, this paper titled "Unresolved subclinical hypothyroidism is independently associated with progression of CKD," this highlighted the topic that decreased thyroid function, there is increased prevalence of decreased thyroid function in CKD, which increase its prevalence increase with increase with decreasing the GFR, and also this thyroid dysfunction affect the GFR. So in, there is an increase in the progression of CKD in patients with unresolved subclinical hypothyroidism. The follow-up period was about 7 years, and they concluded that patients with AU thyroidism, as well as those with resolved hypothyroidism, have the lowest progression as regards the GFR than those with unresolved hypothyroidism, subclinical hypothyroidism. This is not the only bad effect of hypothyroidal function in patients with CKD. These patients are more liable to cardiovascular events, but we should take in consideration that the increased cardiovascular risk in this patient may not be due to the hypothyroid or the disturbed thyroid function, but it may be due to other comorbid status associating the CKD menu in general. Can we replace thyroid deficiency in patients with CKD? This is the only work that was done in this field. It is done in South Korea. They gave the patient thyroxine for the treatment of subclinical hypothyroidism. This study included 113 patients, and they concluded that thyroid replacement tends to decrease the decline in the renal function in patients with CKD. But this is not the rule. The rule that we will not give patients with subclinical or with low thyroid, low T3 or low thyroid, we will not give them thyroxine replacement. In general, there is a lack of evidence of thyroid hormone replacement in this patient, mild elevation of TSH less than 20 with or without T3 and T4 changes will not warrant the supplementation of hormone. So we have to consider the danger of giving thyroxine to this patient, increasing the catabolism and increasing the wasting in such patients. What about hyperthyroidism in CKD? The prevalence of hyperthyroidism in CKD is the same as in the general population. There is no difference. But hyperthyroidism accelerating the CKD. We just mentioned that in patients with hypothyroid function, whether subclinical or low T3, just lower low T3 in CKD, there is acceleration in the or more decline in the GFR, and this is the only mechanism by which thyroid hypofunction affects the kidney. While in hyperthyroidism, we will find other mechanisms through proteinuria, through free radical formation, and increasing renal blood flow, and even activation of the RAS system, which increases fibrosis. Goiter was one of the beauty sign in the ancient people. This is a relief showing Cleopatra. She is one of the beautiful queens in Egypt, and she had goiter. presence of godparent CKD is increased, iodine is normally secreted by the kidney. If we have a kidney, a failed kidney, iodine will be retained in the circulation and will result in enlargement of the thyroid. What about thyroid dysfunction during dialysis? During dialysis, we will have increase in the TSH in 20% of the uremic patient, ranging from 5 to 20. We have decrease in the total T4, but in patient with dialysis, the free form of the hormone is usually within normal due to the effect of heparin on the protein binding. There is decrease in the T3 total and free, but the affection is more on the total. So as regards this menu of decreasing thyroid hormone and increasing TSH, in spite of this, most patients on hemodialysis are actually athyroid. This is because there is increased cellular transport of thyroxine, which maintains the need of the cell, and so the patient is clinically hypothyroid, euthyroid. However, thyroid dysfunction and this milieu of increasing TSH and especially decreasing total or free T3 is associated with increasing cardiovascular mortality. This paper published in 2014 examining about 1,000 diabetic hemodialysis patients in Germany in more than 178 centers in Germany. The endpoint was short-term within 1 year and long-term after 4 years as regards disease, even sudden cardiac death and so on. And they concluded that sudden cardiac death was associated with subclinical hypothyroidism as well as athyroid syndrome, and that athyroid syndrome is associated with mortality in hemodialysis. Regular assessment of the thyroid status may help to estimate the cardiac risk in such patients. This study was done in a diabetic patient, while that one in 2015 was done on non-diabetic, and they estimate the relation between the low T3 syndrome and the mortality in patients on hemodialysis. After a 7-year follow-up, low free T3 was associated with more mortality, the lower line, with more mortality than those with normal free T3. After adjustment, this model was before adjustment, there was a strong correlation between the low T3 and the mortality rate, while after adjustment for other confounder, they found that there is no correlation, so there is failure to retain the power between the correlation between low T3 and the mortality in such patients. Other confounder like age, history of cardiovascular disease, and hemoglobin were more correlated to mortality in patients with hemodialysis. There is also an effect of thyroid dysfunction on erythropoietin. 1,013 patients were categorized according to their thyroidal status. These patients were on hemodialysis. And the conclusion that the dose of erythropoietin increases significantly in patients with hypothyroidism, subclinical hypothyroidism, and diabetic patients. Graves in hemodialysis is not more than in the general population. It can be associated with membranous. The treatment is the same whether with antithyroid or with iodine, radioactive iodine therapy. The dose in hemodialysis as regards radioactive iodine is the same as those with normal renal function. The peak of radiation is about the second day. 70% of the radioactivity is eliminated. eliminated after the first session. There is no need to isolate such patient, and there is no detectable contamination of the dialysis unit, disposable and bed linen. However, after the first session, it seems necessary to collect the waste and the dialysate and put them in a special room for radiation decay. The usual protection barrier are sufficient, mask, gloves, and so on, and there is no risk of external exposure to radiation. What about the take-home message? Patients on hemodialysis have low thyroid hormone level and elevated TSH. Among the CKD patient on hemodialysis, the patient retained his euthyroid state due to increased cellular transport of the thyroid hormone. Low T3 may be associated with poor outcome in dialysis patient. Warning against supplementation with thyroxine in this patient due to its effect on the nitrogen balance. And finally, I would like to thank you and say welcome to Egypt in English and vous êtes bienvenue in français. And thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Ghada, for your excellent presentation. I think we'll be asked by English and French too. So we have questions. We have time for questions. Okay. Yes, please. Use the mic, please.
Thank you very much for the presentation. I want to ask if there is any correlation